everybody. So it's Boba Fett time once again. The Book of Boba Fett episode 3 just dropped on Disney Plus. The series has been a little bit slow out the gate, but I do think the show is ramping up and getting better and better each episode, because I actually did enjoy most of episode 2 between the main story and the flashback sequences. Even if the main storyline didn't get a major push and focus in episode 2, it did have some of the coolest moments, because we got the reveal of the Hutt twins, and the one that was the most cool to me was getting to see Black Chrysanthemum make his live action debut, because that character is so awesome in the comics. Once again, it's a very short episode this week. I thought we were going to get longer episodes after last week's episode, but we're back to under 40 minutes, which, I mean, I want longer episodes, but at least the stuff that we do get for the most part is pretty good. This episode certainly felt like finally the pieces are coming together to kind of figure out what the overall plot of the season's going to be, and our main central conflict and antagonist that's going forward in the series. I know Boba Fett had said previously that he's going to try and just roll with respect, but after this episode, I think that's going to take a little bit of tweaking, but even if we do delve a little bit into the political aspects of him trying to be a ruler, I feel like he's gonna have to try and find that happy medium, because there's just so many different things he has to take care of. Even in this episode, there's a lot of things you have to take care of. You have Steven Root, who makes a fun little cameo in this episode. I love me some Steven Root. Office Space, Dodgeball, so many other things along the way. But he's mad at these people for taking water, of all things. I'm glad that even Boba Fett kind of realized how ridiculous this all was and kept it moving, even hiring these people because they need jobs. You know, Boba Fett's for the people. This is the way you win them over, I guess. Not gonna lie though, I did get a little bit nervous because we had that awesome segment with Boba Fett and Steven Root and all these people. Then we went right back to the Bacta tank, which usually signifies that we're going to have some sort of flashback. But the flashback, I think, is probably the best one. I like the flashbacks, it's just that they're structured kind of weird in the context of the show and how we're trying to move the plot forward. But this one made the most sense, especially by the end. That damn Pike Syndicate, we saw them kind of tease in the last episode, and we get to see them full force talking to Boba Fett in this episode. And they seem to be the main central antagonist of this show, or at least one of them going forward, especially with the way that we find out all the Tusken Raiders have been killed, that he goes back to his town and they're burned up alive. That whole entire segment was just so sad, so haunting. The score by Ludwig Göransson was just fantastic in this segment, as we kind of pay respects to these people as Boba moves on. It was a really sad flashback scene. That was probably the best one of the first three episodes. Like I said in the beginning of the video though, I was excited to see a little bit more Black Chrysanthemum. I didn't think we were going to get more of him in this episode, though, because of the fact he rips Boba Fett out of the Bacta tank and tries to kill him. If anyone was kind of new to Black Chrysanthemum after last week's episode, they hadn't read the comics, know about the character, this is a great introduction to him, having him fight Boba Fett, pretty much winning the battle. He was going to kill Boba Fett, but thankfully Boba Fett had help from his little gang that he had coming together. But Black Chrysanthemum, I mean, he's ferocious. He's taking on all these people at once, and they get lucky, though, because he gets trapped in the Rancor pit. Genuinely, I was really hoping that Black Chrysanthemum would stick around and try and become friends with Boba Fett and they could work together, but once the Hutts appear and they kind of try and apologize for bringing Black Chrysanthemum to try and kill Boba Fett, he just runs away. So who knows when we'll see him next. I hope that's not the last we see of him in the show, but if that is the last that we see of him in the show, you know, what an episode and a half or so of seeing him, because he's an awesome character and he deserves to be in more things. Speaking more on the twin Hutts though, that entire segment did have some fun humor to it because of the fact they show up and apologize, and they're big apology gift is giving him a Rancor. So we have another Rancor that's gonna go into the pit. That was pretty fun. But the best part of that all probably wasn't even the Rancor. It was the fact that we get a cameo from Danny Trejo, Machete himself. It seems very in line with Robert Rodriguez because he loves to put him in all of his stuff. But Danny Trejo was fun. He's Danny Trejo in Star Wars. I mean, that's so kind of cool to think that Danny Trejo now is officially in the Star Wars universe. Just to go back a little bit to talk more about the Twin Hutts thing and just a speculative thing for Star Wars fans. Because of the fact that the Twin Hutts said that another syndicate was promised this area, are we thinking maybe it's Crimson Dawn, like Kira's gonna show up in this show? I actually really liked Emilia Clarke in Solo, so I'd love to see her, you know, her story expanded in some shape or form. But just a nerd out moment, you know, if you know that stuff in the comment section, make sure you leave your thoughts down below. But I think it's crazy to me that Boba Fett is going to potentially try and ride this Rancor. Like, that's going to be one of the most mind-blowing moments, I think, of this series if we actually see that happen. I think it's kind of a given, though. To end off the episode, though, I did think the fun chase sequence we had at the end of the episode, it was very entertaining, very Robert Rodriguez thrown in there. The score also, once again, Ludwig Göransson is just fantastic. He's killing it with the score in the show. What's revealed at the end of the episode, though, with the mayor working with the Pikes, I think that is going to show us what the main conflict and antagonist of this series is going to be, since the Pikes are who killed the Tusken Raiders, Boba's friends, and Boba's going to be pretty angry about that. So like I said, I think he's going to do a little bit more than just win people over with respect. I think he's going to get a little little bit angrier because it's a little bit more personal now. So yeah, all around, another solid episode of The Book of Boba Fett. I think it is still a little bit short. I think we need to have these episodes be a little bit longer, but I guess maybe potentially with the way this episode ended, I don't think we're going to get any more flashbacks, so I guess that's one positive if someone out there doesn't like flashbacks. But let me know in the comment section down below, what did you think of this episode of Book of Boba Fett? Do you like the episode, not like the episode? Share any thoughts or theories you may have on what you think is going to come in the upcoming episodes, because part of the fun is having a conversation with you guys in the comments section. As always, thank you guys for watching. Make sure you like... As always, thank you guys so much for watching. Make sure you like on the video. Also, subscribe to the channel if you haven't already. Check out movie reactions, unboxings, and more. But next time, I'll see you guys later.